Yes, for sure, it's a good thing that we win the game, but it's still early beginning of the season. For us, it's good to see that we can be competitive with teams who has like highest ambitions in LKL. And yes, I hope that we will take some extra motivation from that game and keep going on same way in future.
Trenerio mintis apie rungtynės, nes sakė, gerai, kad laimėjom, esam sezono pradžioje, smagu matyti, kad galim būti kompetityvus žaidžiant su tokiom komandom. Tikiuosi, kad pasimsim motivacijos iš šitų rungtynių toliau eiti į priekį.
Perhaps how disappointed were you with the last, I don't know, let's say 11 seconds or so when you had plus 5 and then also 2 free throws and then it turned out the way it turned out?
I mean, this basketball, so it's plus 5, 2 free throws, the only thing that, you know, we cannot make that footfall. We cannot give them chance to call timeout and bring the ball on another half court. So we all know how Žalgiris didn't go to Final Four with last Tarvidas season. So.
Klausimas buvo per rungtynių pabaigą, treneris sakė, na, čia tiesiog krepšinis, svarbiausia, kad neprasižengėm ten toj situacijoje ir neleidom varžovam išsimest kamuolį iš kitos aikštelės pusės.
Two seconds, just lost the question. Wolves against Jonava Sibet obviously had close to 30 points in fast break. Was stopping their fast breaks and fast possessions one of the focuses before the game? And if so, how did you manage to stop it so well this game?
I mean, it's always easier to play the transition defense if you execute your offense and our players know what we will do. If you start play wild basketball, for sure you will give those kind of teams more opportunity to run, you know, and you are already in that in disadvantaged position. But I think that we control the rhythm. We must be better against their ball pressure. They play very, very, very hard, very good defense, especially Andrews. He surprised me really positively, and you know, like, it's not easy to play against that type of defense. But I hope in future we will react better.
Klausimas buvo apie varžovų greitą puolimą ir jo stabdymą. Treneris sakė, kad visada lengviau žaisti tranzicijos gynybą, kai gerai žaidė puolime. Manau, kad kontroliavom ritmą, turėjom būti geresnį kamuolio spaudime. Nelengva žaisti tokią gynybą, treneris sakė.
Andrei Stepanovic made his debut today. Were you surprised how good shape he is in right now, and what can you say about his game today?
No, I'm not surprised. I know him like, I don't know, 15 years, so I knew that he will be great addition for us, great character, great person, so I wasn't surprised at all.
Klausimas buvo apie Stepanovičiaus debiutą ir ar treneris liko nustebintas. Treneris sakė, nesu nustebintas, žinau Stepanovičiui 15 metų, žinau, kad tai geras papildymas mums. Tai tiesiog geras žaidėjas, geras žmogus ir džiaugiamas, kad jis yra.
Jurgis Kalidzakis was leader on offense today. What can you say about his performance?
I mean, yes, he took some shots, you know, I can say out from the sets, you know, he made. But me as a coach, I want to solve that situation like more through the team game, you know, sharing the ball. But of course, you know, like good game for him. He made those shots. But for me is most important thing how he start the game and he go from the bench with those two steals from defense, and you know, if you start a game like this, for sure you will make those some shots if you are honest to the game. My English not good, but I think you catch point what I want to say.
Klausimas buvo apie Jorgo Kalaidzakio šiandienos rungtynės. Treneris sakė, kad Jorgos metė sunkių metimų, pataikė juos. Man kaip treneriui norėtųs daugiau komandinio žaidimo, bet su laimingas Jorgos pasirodymus. Gerai pradėjo rungtynės jau nuo pat pradžių, be visai aikštelės pusės.
So I wanted to ask about Mantas Rupštavičius. What do you think he added after this year in Australia? What did he bring back to Lithuania?
He's more mature and he came for sure with with experience, I mean, he was with good attitude before, so he just, you know, like become 1 year older and more mature. So it's about everything else. It's for sure not great game for him today, but you know, he won the game. He has my 100% support, and for sure he will help us. Not just him, you know, all the best players will help the team. This is our goal.
Klausimas buvo apie Mantą Rupštavičių, ką jis pridėjo per tą sezoną Australijos lygoje. Treneris sakė, kad Rupštavičius dabar labiau subrendęs, įgavo patirties. Jis buvo geras žaidėjas ir anksčiau, tiesiog dabar įgavo daugiau patirties. Šiandien jam nebuvo pačios geriausios rungtynės, bet jis turi, mano, 100% palaikymą, kaip ir visi kiti žaidėjai.
I think we saw two different games inside the same game. We had a very, very low level of energy, team commitment at the beginning, allowing them to score 52 points, that to be honest is not enough for us. We cannot compete at 100 points every time, especially on the road against the Eurocup team. The second half was completely different, and obviously at the end, if we talk about winning or losing, we are talking about some possessions or episodes, you know, that can go in one way or different way. But to be honest, those are things that we cannot control. What we want to control is the level of the energy we spent in a second half. Obviously, it was tough in order of even mental energy to spend to try to come back into the game until the 72-72. We know, like we already said, that we are still at the beginning, and this is not the level we want to compete in order of performance. We can do better. We must do better. We deserve to do better, only if we understand that the way to do it is starting from the second half.
Trenerio mintis apie rungtynės, trenerio sakė, manau, kad šiose rungtynėse pamatėm dvi skirtingas rungtynės. Pradžioje žaidėm su prasta energija, antra pusė buvo visiškai kitokia. Rungtynių pabaigoje viską nulėmė keletas atakų, keletas momentų. Kartais tokių dalykų kontroliuoti negalima, sakė treneris, bet ką galim kontroliuoti, tai yra energija. Ir būtent ta gera energija leido sugrįžti rungtynės jų pabaigoje. Treneris sakė, kad galim žaisti geriau.
Let's maybe talk about the end of the second half, the last sort of minute or so. Was it what you mentioned, like maybe mental fatigue is how you explain the fact that your players didn't make a foul for about 10 or 11 seconds after the missed shot?
I mean, we are some players is more experienced than the others. Obviously, are things that we already, for example, mention it and watch it, even in the previous games that already happened. Those are things that at the end, if you see, the game is finished by 2 points. So every possession is important. We have to understand very, very quickly that we have to take care about every possession from the beginning to the end, because then every situation matter, like spending foul. I can tell you even the vice versa. When we spent the foul unnecessary with the bonus expired, and we just in a moment where we were really, really playing good defense and Lectabilis was really in trouble to score, we gave them the chance to shoot easy free throws and get easy points. So those are things that we have to try to, as soon as possible, take away. I don't think it's about fatigue. It's that obviously we played, three days ago. We had just one practice, but even Lectabili said the same, just having one day more, and obviously having 56 games in a season, that is what it is. So we have to try to get better even through the games. It's harder just because when you lose, you know, the process is not the same. It's a bit painful, but we have to bounce back and respond immediately. Like I told you, I saw an answer from my team inside the same game, what I didn't see, for example, in the first Eurocup game. But like you said, I agree with you, we have to try to take away from the game these mistakes that at the end cost a lot.
Klausimas buvo apie tuos lemiamus rungtynių momentus. Treneris sakė, kad kai kurie žaidėjai tiesiog yra labiau patyrę už kitus. Tokie dalykai pasitaikė ir ankstesnėse rungtynėse, analizuoja. Treneris sakė, komanda tokias situacijas. Rungtynėse kiekviena situacija yra svarbi. Nemanau, kad tai yra psichologinis nusiteikimas. Tiesiog žaidėm prieš kelias dienas, turėjom tik vieną treniruotę. Bet toks tvarkaraštis, daug rungtynių. Treneris sakė, turim stengtis tobulėti ir būti geresni su kiekvienam rungtynėm.
Talking about the best player tonight, maybe on Lietkabelis team, Kalaidzakis, were you perhaps a bit surprised or, I don't know, caught off guard in a way by his three-point shooting especially? I mean, we know obviously that sometimes, you know, teams take a risk on that. Did you, was that your plan? And then did you have to adjust?
It was not that night. I mean, obviously we gave him a bit of confidence, just you know, because he was able to attack at the beginning. He got confidence. Obviously, if we have to decide to take away something from this player, great player, obviously is the penetration. So we tried to gamble a bit. It wasn't the night to do it. So I mean, I don't regret about the choice we did, just because you have to decide what to do. Obviously, you know, everything starts from the level of aggressiveness you put and the confidence that you are able to give to the players. I think that the confidence we gave to Liechtenstein's team, that is a Eurocup team, is a very well organized and very well coached. So we are talking about an important opponent. So I don't want to disrespect nobody, but I mean, in the first half, obviously we gave them a lot of confidence, so it's easier then to go through that confidence.
Klausimas buvo apie Jorgos Kalidzakį ir jo tritaškius čia. Treneris sakė, taip, prisėmėm riziką. Pradžioje Kalidzakis gavo progą atakuoti, gavo pasitikėjimo. Bandėm šiek tiek rizikuoti su juo, bet šiandien tiesiog buvo ne ta diena. Treneris sakė, nesigili tokio sprendimo. Sendo Lietkabelis yra Europos taurės komanda, gerai treniruojama komanda, bet pirmoji pusėje jai davėm per daug pasitikėjimo.
I know it's always hard to answer immediately after the game, but we saw, I mean, even a couple of situations in the first half where Andrews seemed to have a bit of a knock maybe on his knee or a muscle, and then also at the end of the game, I don't know if it's the same knee or the same problem, but he was struggling to move a bit. Maybe a couple of words about the situation,
yeah,
with Andrews.
Like you said, I saw him I sub him at the end just because it was the end of the game, and I didn't, was, you know, I was clearly limping, and I saw in the locker room, but I don't know what's going to happen. At the beginning, I think it was just a bump, and was, I think, the same knee. I hope it's nothing serious.
Klausimas buvo apie Andrews'o situaciją. Treneris sakė, kad rungtynių pabaigoje po stadionų, nes atrodo, kad žaidėjas nesijaučia gerai. Pradžioj viskas atrodo kaip nedidelis sumušimas, o dabar žiūrėsim. Tikėkimės, kad žaidėjui nenutiko nieko rimto.
Hello, coach.
Hello.
The next game for you is going to be against Hapoel Tel Aviv. How the team is like mentally feeling after the two losses already?
I mean, we are hungry and angry. Just to use words that you can say in front of a camera. Obviously, the goals of this club, the ambition that this club have are really high, and the players same, and the coaches, coaching staff same. Obviously, to build something, you need time. Sometimes you need a bit of lucky. Obviously, we would like to come back to win. But if I have to tell you that tonight we deserve to win, probably no. So the sports sometimes give to the team that deserve more to win the game, and for what they showed for all the 40 minutes, probably we did not even deserve to win. For the will we had in the second half, probably yes, but the meaning is that it's very important, you know, to don't stay too much focus on winning or losses. Obviously we are paid to perform and to win. And obviously is what we work for, but what we need to care is the quality of our game. Because I'm sure that through the quality of our game, if you are able to get better, then the winning games is a kind of consequence of that. So we have to focus game by game, opponent by opponent. Like I told you, we play Tuesday, so we have not a lot of time to work on, but we will do everything is possible to try to go to compete.
Klausimas buvo apie kitas rungtynės ir komandos būseną po dviejų dabar pralaimėjimų iš eilės. Treneris sakė, esame alkani ir pikti, ši komanda kelia aukštos tikslus ir ambicijas, bet kažką sukurti reikia ir laiko, kartais reikia ir sėkmės. Ar šiandien nusipelnėm laimėti, ko gero, nesakė treneris. Antroji pusė, nors ir atrodėm gerai, bet norint laimėti, reikia žaisti visas 40 minučių. Laukia rungtynės antradienį, laiko daug neturim, bet padarysim viską, ką galim, kad pasiruoštumėm.